first loves, and I practiced it intensively when I was a child. He was the main presence as a composer in my life during my years at the conservatory. And you know, I played all the etudes and all four scherzos and ballades and the third sonata, so many pieces by Frédéric Chopin. Now, I always knew I would at some point return to it. The question wasn't if, the question was only when. But it was really nowhere on my, you know, immediate sort of orbit. That morning, you know, I made the decision to go and hear Maurizio Pollini, who was in Tokyo playing an all Chopin recital. And I was delighted for the chance to hear him live. And I just played the night before. And so, you know, I go there thinking, well, this is going to be a beautiful day. And I get into the hall, I sit down, and he starts playing. And I'm listening to him thinking, you know, why do you deprive yourself of this music? Both second sonatas by Chopin and Rachmaninoff deal with the issue of death and how to transcend it so that you can, you know, better live and continue to give as a richer person to others. And, you know, I mean, you have to turn every negative into a strength. And, you know, as painful as loss is, it is something humbling, and because it is humbling, it helps you actually live better, live, you know, brighter and stronger, and being more faithful to who you really are. There's so much warmth, so much sun in those pieces, and actually, you know, it fascinates me how someone of, you know, mostly Slavic soul can so perfectly incarnate, musically speaking, the idea of, you know, something Mediterranean in essence.
Thank you.